And want to welcome everybody to my new Facebook Live experience that I'm doing on the weekends. Getting myself started right here. And we are live. Welcome to Hey Millennial with Emily Correa of Ultimate Spark Coaching. I'm here with a special guest, Liz Hansen. Yes, how are you?
Hi, thanks for having me on, Emily.
Wonderful. So she is actually the founder of Chicago Boudoir Photography. She also has a very large women's group called the VIP Group for Empowered Women of Chicago. Yes. So I wanted to just, well, we know where you're from. You're in Chicago. You're a local, girl like me here. So I wanted to know just more about your background. Tell me about your business and this wonderful group that you have.
Thanks for having me on, Emily. So, boudoir is a French word that means a woman's bedroom. But what it means in a photography context now is a Victoria's Secret style photo shoot for the everyday woman. So, if you want to be fancy in French, you can say boudoir. But most Americans say boudoir. And what I have is a boutique photography studio on Chicago's North Shore. Women come to feel glam, to feel empowered. Professional hair and makeup is included with every session. What you do is you come in, you're going to spend almost a half a day at the studio. We're going to make you look and feel amazing. We're going to show you exactly what to do and get gorgeous images of you. Then, as a bonus, after your shoot, you can get a gift to give to a partner if you want to. So, something like a book like this, it's going to be what you can take home from your shoot.
You know what? I was really confused on how to say this as well. Hopefully, I said it right. Is it boudoir or boudoir?
Yeah, so I say boudoir because I'm an American. But if you
Yes.
want to be fancy, you can say boudoir.
Boudoir. I think this type of photography is so fabulous. I think it allows women to really feel into their womanhood, into the femininity. And then I think also our partners can enjoy the pictures as well.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, most of the women that come to my studio are doing it to celebrate themselves, to feel empowered and confident in their own skin. Of course, a lot of them want to give the gift as a part to a partner as well, but like that's not the main reason most women come into my studio, honestly. They want to feel good about themselves. They want to have some beautiful pictures so that they can look back on. I had a woman in just this last week. She said, "The reason why I'm here is because when I'm 80, I want to pull out this book and look at it and say, look at how I was, you know?"
Right, exactly. You want to look back and you want to value the time that you had when you're young and you feel very vibrant. I mean, ideally, I want to feel like that forever. So I'm always gonna have like this high energy, but like having that visual proof like feels so good,
Yeah,
and
absolutely. And there's no age limit on boudoir. I had a woman who was
right.
67 in the studio just a couple weeks ago. She came in to do it to celebrate her 50th wedding anniversary. So, you know, it's just a beautiful way to feel empowered no matter what your age or your stage or your shape or your color.
Now let's talk about your upbringing growing up. Like, where, how did you get into photography? Is that something that maybe your friends like know about, or maybe a family member was a photographer? I mean, times have changed. Like, there's more and more women doing photography now, which is fantastic, but it's still like a very strong male-dominated field. Can you share how
Absolutely.
you got into photography? Yes.
So, I actually, as a child, wanted to be a photographer, but got talked out of it by people who told me I would never make any money doing it and that it wasn't really a viable career. So, I actually ended up being a teacher, got a teaching degree. I did love teaching as well, but eventually found my way back to my passion, which really was to do photography. And I'm so glad I did. I started out actually taking pictures of families and babies. We lived in Austin, Texas, and I would take you out to a beautiful field and take pictures of you. Well, when a job, my husband's job relocated us to Chicago, and it turns out it's cold here, and I couldn't shoot families outdoors for most of the year. I mean, many, many months of the year here. It's just too cold to shoot comfortably outdoors.
In Chicago,
So,
yeah.
it's just too cold here. It wasn't like Texas where I could shoot year round, you know? So, I ended up getting a job at a photo studio here in Chicago that did some boudoir photography. I'd never heard of it before. I'd never done it before. And I absolutely fell in love with it. So, when that studio that I worked for went out of business a few years ago, I decided to go out on my own and open my own place. And it's just been amazing ever since.
Oh, I love that. And please share, like, What would you tell your younger self? You know, because you said earlier to me that you feel like you are you're not exactly millennial. Can you share more about that?
Yeah, so I turned 40 in about a year. So Ooh. I am, if I'm considered a millennial, I'm like an old millennial, right? Yes. But I'm also a young Gen Xer. So I'm right in between. I had an analog childhood, but I've had a digital adulthood. So I didn't really have the internet till I was in college. Didn't send my first email till I was 19, you know? So I feel like if I could talk to my younger, the world has opened up so much, you know, in the last 20 years with the internet and everything. And if I could tell my younger self anything, it would be that no dream is too big or out of reach. Like I did have this dream as a young child to be a photographer, but it felt unattainable to me. I didn't know any female photographers. I didn't really know any professional photographers. I also didn't know any female business owners. So no one in my family had started a business.
So you're like leading the pack. Basically, you're leading the pack. You're like one of these women, you know, influencers for the field of photography. And like also with your work in Chicago, I mean, you have this really like awesome group. Can you talk more about that? Your women's group here in Chicago?
Yeah, so I have a group with thousands of local women and it's a Facebook group. And we get on there and talk about things that are on our minds. We talk about workplace issues, feminist issues. I get in there and talk about what I'm doing, about how I'm empowering women through boudoir. And occasionally we get together in person too. I love meeting people from my group in person. I just met a few for coffee this week. So yeah, I'd love to have you join the Facebook group and join the conversation.
That's fantastic. And can you please share your links or any way that people can find you and find out more about booking you as well?
Yeah, absolutely. So the best way is my website, which is www.chicago-boudoir.com. If you go there, you'll also find a link to my Facebook group, the VIP group for Empowered Women of Chicago.
Wonderful. Oh, I have one more question. Regarding like the younger generation, now that they're so obsessed with selfies and taking pictures and everything's just documented, it's kind of creepy. I'm like, whoa. But what advice would you give to the younger generation about how their digital presence, like online, you know, how to maybe present themselves the best way online, what not to post, what type of pictures to post, you know, because us professionals, we know like it's really important to do these type of videos, interview style. It's important to have like really nice, clean professional pictures, but because we're in a creative field to express ourselves and to have like style and authenticity with our work. But it's like a really like a hot mess, okay, with what's happening with the younger generations. So what advice would you give to like the younger people taking pictures and being like good on media?
First off, I can consider myself part of the generation as well. Like I'm online all day too. I think the two most important things to remember about the internet is one, nothing is really private and everything is permanent. So like, just because you think you're in a private group or just because you think you're just sending it a screenshot to a friend, it can get out there and be on the internet in half a second and your fourth grade teacher can see it. Your next door neighbor can see it. Everyone can see it, right? So always remember, even things that you think are private, once they're on the internet, they're not private. And we know this, but we forget. You know what I mean? We think, oh, I'm in this private Facebook group. Oh, I'm just texting it to my buddy. It can end up online. And then the second thing I would say is try to remember that there are some things that are appropriate for the internet and some things that aren't, right? Like we all have our personal life and our public life, and we do want to share our authentic selves, no matter what profession we're in. But there are some things that I would recommend just before you hit post, just think, is this something?
I totally say that. Yeah, is this something that I want the whole world to see? And I'm just jumping in because I think a lot of times that people are maybe this younger or older generation, Facebook is not a diary. Like don't share, it's not a journal. Don't share everything that's happening in your life. Don't share all your sad thoughts and you know, all your, like it's not a real reflection as well.
Yeah, I just think especially in our romantic relationships, there are some things that need to stay between me and my husband. I'm not talking about sex. I'm talking about like, do I need to get on there and rant about my husband not doing the dishes?
Exactly. So right.
Not that I'm worried about what other people think about me, but that is damaging between me and my husband. You know, our relationship is not open to the world and I protect it for
reason, because it's important to me. And so, especially with your most important relationships, your relationship with your child, with your husband, with your parents, keep some of that information where it belongs, and don't share every little thing on the internet.
Oh, I love that. So thank you so much, Liz. This is Hey Millennial with Emily Correa of Ultimate Spark Coaching. And thank you for being part of my networking roulette here. Have a great Saturday.
Thanks for having me, Emily.
Okay. Have a nice day. Bye.